Now, you must have learned that le, la, l apostrophe, les, they all mean the, that they are definite articles in French, like le garçon, la fille, l'école, les enfants, and the likes. However, le, la, l apostrophe, les could also mean something else in French. That will be our focus today. Stick around. Now, what are direct objects? So in French, and I believe in other languages, direct objects are nouns that receive the action of a verb. And in French, they often answer the question quoi or qui. In French, for example, I am buying the car, for instance. J'achète la voiture. Okay, so to know the direct object in this sentence, you could ask yourself, j'achète quoi? La voiture. Okay? J'achète la voiture. So, the direct object often answers the question quoi or qui. Or, for instance, je peux voir mon frère. Je peux voir mon frère. I can see my brother. So, if someone were to ask you what the direct object in this sentence is, just ask yourself, je peux voir qui? Je peux voir qui? Who can I see? Mon frère. Okay, and mon frère there is the direct object. Second prix? Alright, we're going somewhere. Just like you know that pronouns often replace noun, so direct object pronouns replace direct object nouns. For instance, je peux voir mon frère. Okay, I can see my brother. If I don't want to keep repeating mon frère, I could replace him by him. Okay, him. So if I wanted to say, I can see him, all I need to do is to replace mon frère with le. Okay? Le in French means him. Okay? So, je peux le voir. Je peux le voir. D'accord? Par exemple, je vois ma soeur. Je vois ma soeur. I see my sister. Okay? If I wanted to replace my sister with a pronoun, I would simply say, I see her. Okay? I see her. That means I see my sister. Okay, so her in French is la. Okay, so I can simply say, je la vois. Je la vois. Now, the question that you may want to ask me is, why is la coming before the verb? Now, the rule says that, unlike in English where the direct object pronoun comes later in the sentence, in French, the direct object pronoun comes before the conjugated form of the verb. Okay, that's what I'm saying. Je vois ma soeur. Je la vois. I see her. So the first thing I did was to replace ma soeur with la, which is the direct object pronoun, and bring la just before the verb. Je la vois. Tu vois ma soeur? You see my sister? How do you say, yes, I see her? Tu vois ma soeur? You see my sister? Oui, je la vois. Okay, instead of repeating, oui, je vois ta soeur. D'accord? Other examples, j'achète la voiture. J'achète la voiture. Okay, so to get the direct object, just ask yourself, j'achète quoi? La voiture. Okay, so la voiture there can be replaced by the pronoun, which is it. So you ask yourself, la voiture, is it masculine or feminine? So apparently it's feminine because of la, and car in French is feminine. So the rule says you turn la voiture, change it to its pronoun, direct object pronoun, which is la, and you bring la where? Before the verb. Okay, so here you have je la achète. But in French, the rule says this is not acceptable. When a word ends in a vowel and the next word starts with a vowel, then you do something called elision. Okay, so you elide the first vowel and replace it with an apostrophe. Okay, so that's why we say je l'achète. Je l'achète. Okay, meaning I'm buying it. D'accord? Other examples, je lis le mail. Je lis le mail. I'm reading the mail. Or je lis l'article. I'm reading the article. Or je lis le journal. So Male, article, journal, their object, direct object. So to tell them, if I wanted to say, I'm reading it, if someone asks me, tu lis le mail, are you reading the mail? And I wanted to respond and say, yes, I'm reading it. I don't need to say, oui, je lis le mail, okay? I could simply say, yes, I'm reading it. And how do I do that? Le mail will be replaced by le, and le comes before the verb. And I can simply say, oui, je le lis. Oui, je le lis. Yes, I'm reading it. C'est bon? Now, I wanted to try this before we go on. Je regarde la télé. Je regarde la télé. I'm watching the TV. How do you say I'm watching it? Mm-hmm. Bravo, bravo. Je la regarde. Je la regarde. Because télé is feminine. Okay? That's why we're using la. D'accord? What about je regarde la lune? La lune means the moon. Or je regarde l'étoile. Okay, the star. Okay, je regarde la lune. All you need to do is to just replace la lune with the pronoun, direct object pronoun, la, and bring la before the verb. You simply have je la regarde. Je la regarde. D'accord? So here are the direct object pronouns used in French. So, like you see in this table, I've tried to put them singular and plural. So we have me or m apostrophe, which can mean me. Okay. We have te or t apostrophe, which can mean you. We have le. Le can mean him or it. Okay. So le can mean him when referring to a human being, or it when referring to a masculine object, a masculine noun. Okay. Now we have la. La can mean her, okay, if you're talking to a feminine gender, or it, if you're referring to a feminine noun, okay? So you know already that in French, we have gender masculine. All objects are either masculine or feminine, okay? So we have el apostrophe. El apostrophe could mean him, it, as long as it starts with a vowel. The verb starts with a vowel. And we have le. Les means them, okay? Them. We also have nous. Nous means us, okay? Us. But if you're using nous as a personal pronoun, then nous means we. But if you're using nous, then we also have vous. Vous, okay? So vous means you as a direct object pronoun. All right, so let's look at some examples. Vous retrouvez Luc et Sophie? Vous retrouvez Luke and Sophie? Are you meeting Luke and Sophie? So if you wanted to prevent saying, yes, I'm meeting Luke and Sophie, you could simply say, oui, je les retrouve. So you could simply say, oui, je les retrouve à midi. Okay? Or if you like, whatever time. So if someone asks you, vous retrouvez vos amis? Are you meeting up with your friends? You say, oui, je les retrouve. Okay? So, les has replaced vos amis, which is the direct object. D'accord? Alright, you should know that me, te, le, la, all turns to M apostrophe, T apostrophe, and L apostrophe before a vowel or a mute H. Okay, for example, je l'achète. Je l'achète. Okay, so because achète starts with a vowel, simply say je l'achète and not je le or je la achète. Okay, so, est-ce que Paul aime le restaurant? Est-ce que Paul aime le restaurant? Does Paul like the restaurant? Oui, il l'aime. Oui, il l'aime. Yes, he likes it. Okay? He likes it. La science m'intéresse beaucoup. La science m'intéresse beaucoup. Science interests me a lot. Okay? So you can see, like in English, where the direct object pronoun comes after the verb. In French, it comes before. Okay, that's why if you wanted to say, I love you, you say, je t'aime. Okay, je t'aime. I love you. So the you there is te, that turns to t apostrophe because of the rule. Okay, now you should know that if the direct object pronoun is the object of an infinitive, then it comes before the infinitive form of that verb. For example, elles vont prendre le métro. Now, with this sense, what's the direct object? Elle va prendre quoi? Le métro. So, to turn le métro into a direct object pronoun, you have to say métro is masculine. So, just turn le métro, replace with le. And the rule says the le will come before the infinitive verb, okay? But not before the conjugated verb this time around. Now, when you have two verbs in a sentence and the direct object pronoun is the object of the infinitive, then the direct object comes before the infinitive form of the verb. So, elles vont prendre le métro turns to elles vont le prendre. Not elles le vont prendre, non. Elles vont le prendre. Tu vas faire le travail? Tu vas faire le travail? Are you going to do the work? Oui, je vais le faire. Not je le vais faire. Ok? Oui, je vais le faire. Oui, je vais le faire. Yes, I'm going to do it. D'accord? Now, I want you to do this before we continue. Il va voir le directeur. Turns to what? Il va le voir. Il va le voir. Bravo. Now, in a negative form, par exemple, tu regardes la télé or tu ne regardes pas la télé. Tu ne regardes pas la télé. Now, the position of the direct object pronoun is just before the verb. Okay? So, tu ne regardes pas la télé. Tu ne la regardes pas. Okay? Tu ne la regardes pas. You don't watch it. Okay? You don't watch TV. Tu ne la regardes pas. Also, when used with voici or voilà. Okay? It comes before voici or voilà. So, you know, voici means here. Okay? Here is. So, if you wanted to say here is he, c'est le voici. Okay? Le voici. That means here he is or here it is. So, if someone was looking for a key, for instance, key in French is la clé. Okay, and you found the key, you can simply say la voici. Okay, la voici, meaning here is it. Okay, same thing, perhaps you're looking for your colleague. Okay, you're looking for your colleague, maybe he went out with you and you see him coming from afar. Oh, you can say, oh, le voilà. That means there he is. Okay, le voilà, le voilà. D'accord? All right, so let's do this activity. I'm going to ask you some questions and I want you to respond using the direct object pronoun. Tu me comprends? Now that's the first question. Tu me comprends? Do you understand me? So how do you say yes, I understand you in French? Tu me comprends? Oui. Je te comprends. Bravo. Or if you like, je vous comprends. Bravo. Oui. Je te comprends. Yes, I understand you. C'est bon? Second question. Je cherche le numéro de téléphone du directeur. Je cherche le numéro de téléphone du directeur. Now, in this sentence, what's the direct object? Yeah, it's just so long, but that's the direct object. Okay, so remember I said to get the direct object, just ask your question, quoi? Alors, je cherche quoi? What am I looking for? Le numéro de téléphone du directeur. So as long as it is, this is the direct object. And as long as it is, you only replace it with le. Okay, because numéro de téléphone is masculine. So how do you say, I'm looking for it? Je le cherche. Okay? Je le cherche. C'est compris?